was a cold Valentine's night. Jessi Klein had invited a group of strangers to a dumpy motel off the interstate for a party. And then a dead man showed up.
Aw, nuts. Who do I gotta blow to have someone not get murdered at one of my parties? Shut up, Rob.
Well, stupid Fresh is also a partner.
I'll take you, you Lithuanian weasel, and I will squish your grapes until you make wine.
Okie dokie, first we make tongue.
Yes, kiss me.
Speaking of getting sick, Jolie Holland, if I had written the alphabet, I would put you and me together.
It's you and I, jackass.
Yes, it is. At least for this one very special night. You and me and old Jaunty over there.
It's Jessi. No thanks.
Guys, can't you see there's a dead man in here? How did this happen, Jessi?
How am I supposed to know, Jolie? I'm just a comedian.
You're a comedian? You want to hear a racy joke?
Well, someone's been murdered. But sure, go ahead.
Awesome. A Polack, a Mexican, and a Jew go into a bar.
Wait, is this racy or is this racist?
I don't know. I'm pretty sure it's racy.
Well, and what's the punchline?
Hey, that's not a kielbasa. Huh?
That could go either way.
Oh, but I have a racist joke. So, a Lithuanian, a Russian, and a Latvian on boat in the Baltic Sea. Okay. Now, the Latvian pull out a bottle of vodka. The Russian kill the Latvian and drink vodka, and then Lithuanian wait until Russians sleep. Then he kill him. That's the joke. He's a stupid Russian.
Oh, you think that was a sexy joke? I will tell you a sexy joke. Little man named Piccolo swallowed whole cucumber.
What? Oh, Jesus, Jolie Holland, you're just like me.
Because I'm sick of your dicking around. Somebody needs to focus on this dead body.
Singer-songwriter is right. Somebody phone the police.
No!
Well, why should we phone the police?
Jolie Holland doesn't do police.
Does Jolie Holland do magazine sales books?
We cannot call the police because of martini in country illegally.
Okay. I also have to admit something. I know this dead man. But I didn't kill him! And I know about the balls of Cupid too. I actually have them in my possession once.
Me too. Those balls are like magic.
I thought I was the only one.
Yeah, me too. Stupid Fresh again wants to fondle dead man's pearly balls.
So who was this guy?
I know him too. I invited him tonight. He used to be the drummer for Winger.
You invited Rod, Stupid Fresh, and the ex-drummer from Winger to this singles mixer?
Well, actually he drummed for Swinger. It was a Winger cover band. They also covered the Go-Go's. I thought it was cute.
Sound too stupid Fresh, like all have balls of Cupid in common. Even dead men.
So who of us killed him?
Well, I would never murder someone for those pearls, but I did. It did do something terrible.
What did you do?
I exposed my genitals at the pottery barn.
Oh, that's quite a picture.
You saw pictures? What'd you think?
Why did you want them? Were you going to sell them and make $1 million?
No, I just wanted to score chicks with them. Oh, I tried everything. Puppies and babies. They even got a job once. But none of those things work, like the balls of Cupid. They drove the ladies wild.
I did something bad to get them, too. I mugged somebody on the street.
That is pure evil.
But I really wanted them. They would have looked so great on stage.
Oh, then that is fine. Did you commit a crime together too, Jessi?
Sort of.
What did you do?
I was mean to a kitten.
You should be ashamed! Stupid fresh spit on the ground on which you step your terrible feet!
I know, I feel awful. But Cupid's balls work perfectly in a sketch I was writing about the teabaggers. I really am a horrible person for being mean to that kitten. Did you do something bad to get your hands on the pearls, Stupid Fresh?
Yes, yeah, Stupid Fresh murdered a priest.
Jeez, that's awful.
What? No. Perhaps I say something wrong. You see, my English is not too good. What I meant to say was, I take long knife and I stick it into priest many times until he is no longer among the living.
I see. The balls of Cupid, these priceless Italian pearls, are cursed. They have caused each of us to do terrible things.
What did you do, Martini?
I already tell you, I am in country illegally. I take low-paying menial labor from a decent, hard-working middle American.
That's abhorrent. All I did was mug somebody.
Yeah, all I did was the Swedish helicopter of Pottery Barn.
And I punched a kitten in the face.
You punched the kitten in the face? You disgust me!
You killed a priest.
What did the kitten ever do to a comedian?
Listen, God, it's not your business. Why don't we sell the balls of Cupid to someone we don't know and split the money evenly? That way we get those pearls out of our lives forever, the curse ends, and we all get rich.
Steal them from the dead guy? Is that ethical?
What do I look like, the Pope? If you don't take my offer, I'll pray all to the police.
You'll do what?
Report them all to the police. Look, all I did was punch a kitten and get a fine. You guys would all either go to prison or be deported.
I go back to my cell.
Your plan will not work, Jessi.
Oh, why not?
Because this is your party, and there's a dead body on the floor. And a martini, know which one of you killed him.
Radio Happy Hour presents The Curse of the Balls of Cupid. Brought to you by Chocolate Men, the chocolates with the medicine inside. Say, Jolie Holland, you don't look so well. Would you care for a chocolate?
Why don't you shove it, announcer?
Oh, okay. Chocolate Men. Delicious chocolates, powerful medication. Get yours while supplies last.